Hey sweeties, how are you doing? Welcome to Simnaya. If this is your first time of coming across this channel, sweetheart, smash that subscribe button, turn your notifications so you are notified each time I upload. And please give this video a thumb up. I appreciate you all so much and thank you so much for the support and love you all showering me here with. So this video is something that I found very, very interesting. And it's about a pump colored man who actually said that a lot of people are already saying that they are not going to vote for Joe Biden due to what is going on. I mean, what he is doing and how he's using taxpayers' money to support what is going on and the Palestine and Israel problems and all that. And pop color people are actually coming out to say that you all are saying you're not going to vote for Biden. I mean, how do you want to vote for the other person? Because you said, because of what he has done and all that, it means that you people are going to, like, you know, probably regret it and all that. I mean, he is indirectly campaigning for Joe Biden, so he is telling you all to go vote Joe Biden, and that because they do not want Trump to be the next president and all that. You know what, I am rolling this clip, we'll come back to talk about it. Let me know what you all think in the comment section. So let's get into it.
Listen, this is really important, and this one's for all the people who are saying that they're not going to vote for Joe Biden in 2024 because of what's happening in the Middle East. By punishing Joe Biden, by not voting for him, you are punishing yourselves and millions of other Americans. This is a gift to the Trump campaign. Republicans have been trying for years to make it harder for people to vote in swing states and states around the country, but especially young people, people of color, minorities, and more. By sitting on the sidelines saying, I'm not gonna vote for Joe Biden, you are doing what they want. You are giving a gift to the Republicans. And look, the policy that Donald Trump and the Republicans will pass if they win and if everybody sits on the sidelines will be disastrous. It will be far worse than Donald Trump's first term. So when it comes to Joe Biden, you don't have to love him. You don't have to like him. You don't have to like voting for Joe Biden. But please compare Joe Biden to the alternative, not the almighty, of which is a president you fully agree with and is fully morally in line with you. This is a very complex issue with what's happening in the Middle East. I can assure you that the Biden administration is doing their best, and this is not a reason to give this country back to the Republicans, who will treat Palestine significantly worse than any Democrat ever will. Please, let's be logical with this stuff, folks. Come on. Listen, this is really important, and this one's for all the people who are saying that they're not going to vote for Joe Biden.
I'm going to sit right here and try to address white liberals real quick. It might be long, it might not, but the thing that kills me about motherfuckers who demographic vote for red 50% of the time, more than 50% of the time, actually 55% for males, 55% for males, maybe females, I don't know, but it's one of y'all motherfuckers, is that y'all will sit right here, big shit talk with the enemy. It's your moms, it's your dads are the enemies, and y'all will sit right here, sitting at people's tables, talking about something we shouldn't talk about politics, but want to don't talk about politics no fucking time, but want to sit right here and tell the motherfuckers who demographic vote for red the least that, oh yeah, if you don't vote for blue, it's your fault if the red oppresses you. I'm not voting for a red. It's your mom and dad doing it. How the fuck is my fault that red is being put into these position of power when it's your people's vote for them? That's the thing that really bothers me. You're blaming marginalized groups for why your mama and pappy are voting red. Don't do that. Like, for one, don't do that. If you want to sit right here and try to convince me, at least put another color up here and try to convince me so I could tell them off in a different way. And then on top of that, they sit right here. And the thing about it is, they sit right here. He sat right here and said, oh, yeah, we need to keep prevent the red from becoming president because they're already trying to prevent swinging states from voting. They're making it harder for swinging states to vote. So when the fuck had you been addressing these swinging states before you try to free-market us into voting blue? And I'm not just talking about him. I'm talking about, like, the general collective of the Liberal Party. When the fuck had y'all been addressing this issue before y'all started trying to free-market us? Cause this is like a big issue with y'all motherfuckers, especially like the white liberals. Y'all love to wait till shit happens and then tell us, oh yeah, it's happening, we should protest, we should write petitions. It's too late to do all that shit. It's too late to do all that shit. Why the fuck am I voting for your peoples into a position of power when I have to protest every fucking thing and petition every fucking thing because y'all failing to prevent these issues from happening? Y'all failing to address these issues until it's happening, and it's happening, it's affecting you some way, somehow. I shouldn't be doing that shit. And then, and keep it above with you, this ain't even the first time white liberals been doing this shit. Y'all sit right here, wait till issues happen. Wait till issues happen. Y'all sit here, ignore everything black and brown women said when it came to that abortion right. Motherfuckers ain't saying nothing about it, like they ain't heard us, like they ain't see us, none of that shit. But when it started happening, they told us, yeah, we should go out and protest and petition, dollars, dollars. And that time, black women said, we ain't doing shit. We was locked in that year because everybody was like, we're not protesting shit. They try to fearmonger us. First of all, the main straw that really, really made me stop fucking with white women when it came to issues about women's right ever was when they said right here, took a song from Tupac that was about black women and made that shit about them. And then when we sit right here and talk and told them about it, they told us to shut your black ass up. They basically told us to shut our black asses up. They said this is not about y'all. We can still use this for all women too. Shut your black asses up. Like that was literally my last straw. I every time when it came to women's issues, I did not listen to these bitches ever again. Yeah, and then sit right here and then on top of that, told us that we're the ones most affected by this issue, so we should be the ones out here protesting the most. okay, so we been knew y'all thought that in the first place, but to say that out loud and still expect us to protest is fucking crazy. That was crazy as shit. They literally sat here and said, well, y'all black bitches are the ones most affected by this issue, so why the fuck y'all black asses ain't out here protesting? And I'm like, whoa. I'm like, whoa, y'all really said that? And then the thing about it is, like I said, like, this thing about it, y'all think our people survived 400 years of oppression. What's the fuck 400 more, right? What's the fuck 400 more? Y'all, you dead, like, you dead as fuck. You think I'm gonna do more work than you trying to prevent issues that we all affected by just because I'm the most affected by it? You dead as fuck. Like, honestly, y'all some dead ass motherfuckers. You think I'm about to do that? Literally, this is like some shit that's gonna happen. Y'all gonna have to sit right here and let everybody be oppressed and stop trying to fight everybody's fucking fight. Stop trying to do the most to fight everybody's fight and let these motherfuckers be oppressed just like us. Be oppressed just like us. Let them feel how shit is for us for a change until they start acting the fuck right. And if they don't, well, good luck, Charlie.
White liberals will never fearmonger me into voting for anyone. Because I've seen white liberals. Martin Luther King talked about white liberals. Kwame Ture, aka Stokely Carmichael, talked about white liberals. I've experienced white liberals to my face. You know how when I was 24, I organized a anti-Donald Trump protest in Eugene, Oregon. I organized it with some of my friends. We were all like in our early 20s. I was also experiencing domestic violence and had recently escaped from my abusive relationship, but I still found the time to organize that protest. There's a man who was a white man who was supporting us in that protest, but then he said that police should know where we're going and our route. I said, this is not a parade, it's a protest. And then he tried to argue with me, so I kicked him out of my house. And then another time when the media wanted to talk to me, even though I don't really talk to the media, a white woman got in front of me and was saying, oh, well, I've been doing this longer than you, this is my time. I'm the one who organized it, though. White liberals, your time is up. Just know that white liberals will never...
This is all I got from this video, and this really tells you how most of them, like, you know... I saw some things going on the internet about them, white people telling black people not to vote in the coming election. Why are they saying that? Because they know how powerful black people are and how huge black people are. And they know that they are also ready to vote. And they are telling them already not to vote because, like, you know, and why would they tell black people not to vote? Because they want to do the same thing they always do. Vote against their own interest so that black people will not benefit from anything or something. See, not until I am not like campaigning for anybody or something, but not until they are ready to get it right this time around. I mean, black people aren't going to wake up and vote somebody that is not going to help them or somebody that will, you know, come into power and make their life 10 times worse than it used to be and all that. or coming to tell you make America great again, like it was all great for black people and all of that. So I am sure that everyone is already, and I am sure you already know who you're going to vote for the next coming election and all that. What I am saying may not change your mind and all of that. But what I am trying to say is that I hope you vote for someone that will not make your life miserable. Like, they are already going around campaigning and the rest of it. That is all I got to say. Thank you so much, and see you all in my next video. Bye for now.